10 at 10 continues with No Wait Weather.
Well, I'd say as we head into the overnight, things won't be quite as active as we've had throughout the afternoon. That's good. I'm picking up a lot of rain. That'll be a problem. And we are still seeing a few thunderstorms that we'll have to keep our eyes on. But I couldn't help but keep my eyes on this. Take a look at our time lapse from this evening. This is post-storm here in the Fargo-Moorhead area as we headed beyond the 7 o'clock hour. And it's peering off to the west, and just the clouds percolating up in the sky, those cumulus clouds. Look at the sun's rays as it was setting in the sky. And there's some thunder showers trying to form out to the west there, kind of dumping more rain on the scene. And now things quieting down, heading into the late night hours. Here's a look at your current conditions. We have rain reported at Hector, 65 degrees. Wind from the southeast is blowing at 6 miles per hour. Want to take you through this real slowly and talk about the rain from Bemidji and Point South into parts of Hubbard County and near Park Rapids. These are good old-fashioned soaking showers. A couple of rumbles of thunder possible with these, and that includes all of Becker County. Not much thunder and lightning left from these particular cells here, just soggy soakers, you might call them. But for Otter Tail County and Wilkin County, and as we move off to the south and to the west towards the Roberts County, South Dakota area in Sisseton, these storms still have a little bit of a potent punch and quite a bit of lightning associated with them as well. And now we're tracking these guys right here. There's one in northwest Cass County, a cell that's popping up there. Here's another cell that's moving over Valley City. If you're hearing rumbles of thunder, they're back again. Now, some storms are quite strong and possibly could contain some sizable hail. Here's a look at this storm track. The radar estimating the possibility for 1.8 inch diameter hail. This algorithm or program in the radar sometimes overestimates the size, but some sizable hail possible in the Valley City and Litchfield areas as we speak. Looking off to the east, this green box, basically northern portions of Richland County down to the southeast, flooding could be a problem where we talked about earlier. Over 5 inches of rain has fallen today in these areas as estimated by Doppler radar throughout the day. 62 Grand Forks, it's been quiet in Devil's Lake and 66 there. Cool air spilling into the entire region now after 80s in the south. We're down in the mid-60s in Lakes Country. Your hour-by-hour forecast overnight shows that we'll have thunder showers continuing to slowly track across the southern Red River Valley, across into parts of west-central Minnesota. As we go through the deep hours of the overnight, it will continue to bring rain to these areas. So first thing in the morning, as you're getting ready for your Friday, it does look like we could have some problems with flooding. If you're traveling on rural roads, low water crossings, turn around, do not drown, do not try to walk or drive through any rapidly moving water. Temperatures in the 50s. Look at this. We're in the 50s all day. Gusty north winds, gusting to 25 to 40 miles per hour throughout the day. It's going to feel pretty brisk compared to the 80s we had. We will peak at temperatures briefly in the 60s in Fargo, but most of the day will be spent in the 50s region-wide. Like this snapshot at 3 o'clock, you can see eastern North Dakota, a lot of 50s, upper 50s in Jamestown, Valley City, same for you, 57 Fergus Falls, 55 though in Bemidji with windy conditions everywhere. Ah, the calm after the storm. Saturday, nice and quiet, a cool day. 67 degrees, a little bit below average for this time of the year. And Sunday, for you graduates out there, it looks like we could have a late day shower or thunder shower, but only 20% of the area will get measurable precipitation. A better chance comes by midweek. We'll have increasing shower and thunderstorm chances with increasing temperatures into next week. We'll keep our eyes on the skies for you tonight. There will be a few more thunder showers out there, but the real risk for the severe storms has diminished substantially.
Okay, that's good.
Yes.
Thank you, Hutch. Well, still ahead for us, Amazon expanding its fast shipping. The new cities where you can get packages the same day.
Up next, another health benefit of switching to a Mediterranean diet.